Hello and welcome to the second part of the PIM Electrolysis Technology Unit. We will explain here in details the different components and PIM electrolysis cell structure. We can see here in detail the cell structure of an electrolysis PIM cell, which allows us to see the different components that contains. The electrochemical active central component is the membrane electrode assembly, or MEA. This part is composed of a solid polymer membrane, number one, coated on each side by two porous layers of electrocatalyst that correspond to number two, one at the anode for the oxygen evolution reaction and the other at the cathode for the hydrogen evolution reaction. The membrane electrode assembly is usually clamped between two porous current distributor made of sintered titanium particles that are identified with number 3. Beside that, two hollow bipolar plates, number 4, are used to convey electricity current to the cell and separate two adjacent cells. Channels are used to carry feed water to the anode and to collect liquid gas mixtures in each cell compartment. Number 5 shows the contact point between current collectors and electrocatalytic layers, which are critical. In fact, the average distance between contact points must be sufficiently small, typically several micrometers, to obtain a good distribution of current lines at interfaces. Finally, the end plates are connected to the external DC power supply and mechanical soft peripheral gaskets are required to seal the cells. In these cells, the membrane is at the same time an electroseparator as well as an electrolyte. During operation, liquid water is pumped through the anode compartment and sometimes also through the cathode compartment for the purpose of heat management. The mass flow of liquid water is therefore larger than the flow required to sustain the electrolysis reaction. In terms of mass flow, the flows of molecular hydrogen and electrosmotic water at the cathode are collinear. On the other hand, at the anode, there is a counterflow of gaseous oxygen from the anodic catalytic layer back to the main stream of liquid, as we can appreciate here in the figure. With such design, gases do not evolve in the interpolar area and do not induce parasitic ohmic resistance at high current density, when the gaseous production is such that individual gases bubbles tend to coalesce and form resistive gaseous film. The price to pay for such arrangement is the sophisticated mass transport structure that are required to facilitate gas extraction away from the reaction sites. In a PIM water electrolysis cell, gases formed in the catalytic layers are extracted at the rear of the membrane electrode assembly through porous transport layers press against the catalytic layers. We can focus now on the different components we just mentioned separately, starting with the solid polymer electrolytes. Perfluorosulfonic acid became the standard for PIM water electrolysis applications. Perfluorosulfonic acid ionomers offer sufficient advantages to meet market requirements despite some limitations. Among these limitations, we can find a somewhat limited temperature range of operation, a significant sensitivity to hydrogen-oxygen cross-permeation, a sensitivity to chemical corrosion, and a dissolution at elevated anodic potentials. The most popular of the perfluorosulfonic acid membranes was developed by DuPont de Nemours and met with great success under the brand name of Nafion. The use of metallic reinforcement with polytetrafluoroethylene clothing or alternative materials can improve the situation. For example, it can achieve a reduction in cross-permeation, but this always leads to the necessary trade-off between proton conductivity and gas cross-permeation. Regarding the different parts of the membrane electrode assemblies, we can say that carbon-supporting platinum nanoparticles are used as the electrocatalyst at the cathode for the promotion of hydrogen evolution reaction. On the anodic side, Iridium is the most efficient and stable catalyst for the oxygen evolution reaction in acidic media. Electrocatalyst particles are deposited on both sides of the perfluorosulfonic acids membrane to form micrometric thick catalytic layers. The composition and microstructure of these catalytic layers are of critical significance since they dictate the overall cell efficiency and also, to a large extent, the durability and the performance. What matters most here is the surface adherence and maximum activity. As for the coating processes, there are several options available to form the electrocatalytic layers. For example, they can be deposited directly onto the solid polymer electrolyte or onto the current distributor, which is then hot pressed against the membrane. Fabrication processes for coating membranes with a catalyst to form a catalytic layer include electrode plating, which is the deposition of catalysts on the membrane either by direct coating or using various techniques, for example by spraying, or via the so-called decal transfer method. Recently, magnetron-based sputtering was successfully used to fabricate nanostructured thin film electrodes for PIM water electrolysis. Let's see now what are the characteristics of the current gas distributors. At the anode, titanium-based porous transport layers are usually used to convey electric current from the bipolar plate to the anodic catalytic layer, to transport liquid water from the anodic compartment to the anodic catalytic layer, and to collect and transport gaseous oxygen from the anodic catalytic layer back to the anodic compartment. They are usually manufactured by thermal sintering of titanium powders. Here, there are several properties need to be optimized, mainly the porosity, surface state, and thickness tolerance. At the cathode, a titanium porous transport layer can be used as for the anode. As we just mentioned, the porosity needs to be adjusted very carefully. This is because they play a central role in mass transport between bipolar plates and catalytic layers, in the mechanical compression of the seal, and in the homogeneous distribution of current lines at the interface with the catalytic layer. An optimum porosity should lie somewhere in the 35% and 50% range for operating current densities up to 2 amps per square centimeter and atmospheric pressure. However, more porous structures are required for higher current density values. In a PIM cell, there is a need to manage a void section parallel to the current collectors. Through this section, liquid water can be pumped and it is there where gaseous reaction products are collected. This can be done with spacer and flow disruptors, and several technology options can be used. The first one is a matching growth thick bipolar plate equipped with flow channels, and to use a cell spacer that is sufficiently thick. At the periphery, a polymer sealant of appropriate mechanical properties is used to ensure water and gas tightness, and to facilitate the distribution of compression forces in the filter press configuration. On the other hand, another option is to use flat and thin bipolar plates and to place flow disruptor between the bipolar plate and the porous transport layer. Such designs are less expensive than the flow field design and can facilitate maintenance. Finally, for the bipolar plates, bulk titanium plates are normally used. Although bulk electronic conductivity of titanium is much lower than that of other metals, titanium is most interestingly prone to surface oxidation and chemically stable in the environment of PIM water electrolysis cell. Individual cells are usually stacked together to adjust the production capacity of the electrolytes to process requirements. We can see the different stacking configuration in the figure. The first one is the monopolar design, which is a design of PIM cells connected in parallel. A better design consists of a series of connection of these cells. The most popular and simple design is to apply the stack voltage directly between the two end plates as shown in the second figure. Alternative, a central anode or cathode can be used as it is shown in the last picture. The challenge here is to use a proper design that ensures the homogeneous distribution of liquid water over the entire surface area of anodic catalytic layers and the efficient collection of production liquid gas mixtures. Homogeneous distribution of current lines across the stack is also another key challenge that needs to be appropriately managed in order to avoid unacceptable high degradation rates. In PIM water electrolysis stack, polymer-based sealants are used to adjust compression forces, to delineate the volumes of individual cells, and to support the difference of pressure between the cells and the atmosphere. For safety reasons, it is better to ensure a flow of pressurized inert gas across the pressurization vessel during electrolysis. This is done in order to remove traces of leaking hydrogen or oxygen that would otherwise tend to accumulate inside the vessel. Therefore, during electrolysis, two high pressure pumps are used for the circulation of pressurized liquid water in both anodic and cathodic compartments. The photograph shows a 1 MW multi-stack design rectangular cells with a 0.2 second of time response and 75% of efficiency. Circular geometry is usually preferred for a small system. However, when the active surface area increases, square geometries are preferable even for operation under pressure. They are more suited to automate manufacturing procedures and to reduce cutting faults. As we have said before, one key advantage of the PIM cell is that the ionic charge carriers remain trapped within the polymer foil. This offers the possibility to use high-concentration protonic electrolytes without the management of corrosion issues. However, this advantage is somewhat counterbalanced by the fact that the manufacturing tolerance of polymer foils is very high. As a result, all internal cell components must be adequately flat and matching with a much higher tolerance than those used in liquid electrolyte cells in order to avoid parasite and even contact resistances. Therefore, the challenge is to optimize the seal design in such a way that, firstly, the electronic resistance of non-membrane electrode assembly cell component is as low as possible. Like this, the externally applied cell voltage is used only to overcome the membrane electrode assembly resistance. Secondly, liquid water can be pumped through the anodic compartment with a minimum pressure drop. And finally, liquid water can be homogeneously transferred to the anode through the pores, letting at the same time gaseous oxygen flow counterclockwise from the anode to the anodic bipolar plate. In the anodic compartment, the situation is simpler because flows of both liquid water and gaseous hydrogen are linear from the cathode to the cathodic bipolar plate. All these constraints are satisfied mainly by controlling the pore structure of the current distributors. These aspects have to take into account the maximum current density or gas production rate and the nominal operating pressure as the diameter of gas bubbles vary with pressure. With this, we conclude the second part of the unit about the PIM electrolysis technology.